गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, एनवायरमेंटल लेजिस्लेशंस। प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड बीन लर्न दैट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सोशल इश्यूज ड्यू टू एनवायरमेंट एंड देयर सॉल्यूशंस। Today we are going to detail about legislations, law. So law has been defined how to protect the environment. The law made by legislators in central government by MPs and state government by MLAs. So people only formulate these legislations to protect the environment. The fact is that this all the law tried to define how to control the environment. Mainly how to control the people activities. You know, environment damage by people only, and various provisions. So first legislation is that Environmental Protection Act. Second, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act, Wildlife Protection Act, Forest Conservation Act. So this every aspect of the environment has been protected by legislations. This legislation also emphasizes what are the health impact and how to preserve the environment to promote environment health, which is directly impact on the health status of people in this society. Students, the main highlights of this legislations are this setup of the board means a organization, for example environmental protection boards, air prevention and control board, water prevention and control board. This is organization try to control the environment. And concerning various environmental issues, in water environmental issues and water air, and solve that issues by these boards. So these all the legislation having various provisions. This punishment, who violate law, for example anybody do harmful to air, is punishable crime according to these legislations, having various listed various punishments as well as this fine and imprisonment are listed by these legislations. Now we are going to detail about each legislations. Environmental Protection Act first. This act was enacted in 1986. Its important constitutional implications, international background, is why enact this legislation is that main background is that United Nations Conference on Human Environment in Stockholm in June 1978. So implement that guidelines given by the United Nations, every nation need a legislation, law. So India enact this law, created this law to protect the environment. Then, law that control land use, protect national park, sanctuaries, wildlife, then growing risk of environmental accidents and control it, and decision making to control it, this environment. Next legislation, the Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act. This was enacted in 1981, clean up air by controlling pollution. Main source of air is that industry, vehicle, power plant, land, carbon monoxide. This is some of the important air which is caused to pollution, damage to air, nitrogen oxide, then some organic compounds, toxic substances. Then this, according to this legislation, has been defined a setup of pollution control board, air pollution. So this board concerning issues in the air pollution, we can complaining to this board. Any, for example, nearby any type of air pollution is there, we can directly inform to this authorities, can take immediate action to control the pollution, air pollution. The main objective of this is that prevention and control of air pollution. Then establishment of central state boards. Central board means central government control it. State means, for example, each state, for example, Tamil Nadu government having a state air pollution control board. So state people can complain to this authorities. Any issues not solve this in state board, that issue goes to this central board and try to solve it. Then power to implement the provisions, board functions, implement every state's. Then power and functions of central and state board, implement the legislations. Then control air pollution in the country, every in the city, in urban, rural, villages. Then state control board, power to advise to state government and concerning air pollution issues. Then having various provisions regarding punishable imprisonment, then fine, for example, 10,000 worth in case of continuing offense, with additional fine with extended up to 5,000, as well as imprisonment, some kind of these offenses. Students, the law only this control the people by means of definite rules and regulations. But various provisions in this law are difficult to implement. Reason is that India are diverse. In the villages, people don't know about illiteracy. So that what can individual do to control the pollution? So we don't think about law. Think about self, how to control our environment. That's why emphasize the law. So there is no question, every individual responsibility, okay, to control the air pollution. So first individual responsibility is that to control air pollution. For example, polluted vehicle, road transport, for example, this road transport officer, pollution control board, these all the members having can able to control the air pollution in the road. So we can inform to these members or authorities. Next one is that observe an industry pollution air and information, the pollution control, for example, any industries nearby our house, okay, any industries in our villages over emitting the pollutions, we are difficult to living in the houses, that time we can this complaining to this pollution board. Then, so that is our responsibility to concerning the our other, for example, any industries, road, any car may be emitting the more this carbon monoxide. That time we can complain with these authorities, our responsibility, right to complaining. Next is that our own responsibility. For example, do not try to avoid this vehicle which is emitting the over the carbon monoxide, etc. For example, use walk and cycle and prevent unnecessary the use of fuel. Then public transport. You know, mainly in the city places, every individual having their own vehicle and use lot of energy. So that advice is that use public transportation to reduce it. Then share vehicle spaces. You know, the vehicle is main cause to. Then do not. Next, do not use air fresheners. For example, AC, we can use, but quality, for example, the some AC may have don't have CFC. Then do not smoke in public place, which is dangerous, you know, to secondary smoking. Then causing can spread bacteria, virus, hand. Students, this is individual matter. When you cough, can spread bacteria and virus. That time, what will you do? Use handkerchief. Nowadays, we have been experiencing, you know, COVID-19. The main is droplet infections. So nowadays, government advised to face mask. You know, this is the reason why. So, which is not airborne, is what a droplet. So, we need everyone individual responsible to be away from this type of airborne as well as droplet infections. Next legislation, water prevention and control of pollution. Water is a basic need of every individual, as we know that. If water polluted, various diseases waiting for us, waterborne diseases, which is linked with, you know, vector-borne diseases, you know, mosquitoes, produced in the water and cause various diseases. So this law tried to protect the water and provide definite rules and regulations. Next, this was formulated in 1974, agricultural and household water prevent pollution. Mainly, you know, look at this, rivers, lakes, falls, as well as seas are serious health hazards when individual activities may harm it to water. The functions of Pollution Control Board, look at this. So this is a separate board set up by this legislation, advised to set up and define what are the functions of Pollution Control Board, water pollution. Suggested penalties, violation of the provisions of the Act. Then Central State Water Test Laboratories. So this is one of the important information. They frequently test water quality in all over the state, in villages, in cities. Then power and functions of the board. First, power is that advice to central government. Central board advice to central government. State board advice to state government. What are the water issues? Water quality issues? What are the programs need? You know, water improvement program and preservation program, etc. Quality program. This board has also the coordinate this program, not only this government aspect as well as non-governmental organizations. Join hand with and try to improve the water quality. So already we have discussed about the state board, advice to state government. Then this legislation having various provisions regarding imprisonment, fine, etc. Then next is that what individual do? What we can do? For example, first inform. We feel any places water are going to having polluted by in some institutions or any industries, right to inform to control Pollution Control Board. Then do not dump waste directly under any water body. So this individual response, for example, every families may be, family members may be waste and into the water in river, nearby river. We could see in, you know, our villages. So these all these should be avoided to prevent water pollution. Then do not use toilets and carefully use and cause water pollution. Use composite instead of chemical fertilizer. Students, this is the agricultural sector. For example, farmers need to responsible. These do not try to avoid these chemical fertilizers and try to impose the biofertilizers. Then pesticide, as we know that, for example, in Kerala, one of the, you know, endosulfone used by in this cashew nut. Nowadays, that one village, one area affected by that, due to that pesticide, the genetic effects. So in agriculture, try to avoid chemical fertilizers and try to improving this biofertilizer to in agriculture. So these are the individual responsibility. Next is that the Wildlife Protection Act. So same legislation having same kind of the principles, is a board available as well as describe various punishment. Also listed in the wildlife concern, listed various dangerous species. For example, deer, black deer, and as well as tiger. Anybody disturbing by this, any person which is punishable crime. Every day we newspapers we could see in that this type of people activities and what do government. This act passed in 1972. This legislation tried to increasing the national park, for example tiger and elephant, deer, then wildlife sanctuaries, then setting up wildlife advisory board. As we had discussed, the advisory board advised to the government and study the wildlife issues and advise to the government. Government formulate various program to solve that problems. Next is that punishable imprisonment. Already we have discussed, for example fine 25,000 rupees as well as 3 years of imprisonment for various crime. What can an individual do? As same as you know, this law is a quasi power, but individual responsibilities, there is no question. We are spontaneously try to protect our environment, our the animals, mainly is wild animals. So which is animals have been protect this, they preserve the forest, which is essential for good air as well as good water, you know, water and air. See a poaching animal inform to local forest. Anybody seen that any animals poaching that time? We are responsible to inform to forest department. Then say no to the use of wildlife products. Then reduce the use of wood, for example sandalwood. You know, sandalwood is a forest in various places, but they illegally use that wood. Avoid misuse of paper. Paper only from the trees, from the, for example, bamboo trees. And reuse the paper. Then create a pressure group, which means we can organize a new NGO, pressure groups or association to protect the wildlife. And do not harm animals. Do not disturb birds' nest. Then visit the zoo, do not tease it. For example, when you go to these zoos, only see and do not tease it. And injured animals, can you see anywhere injured animals, try to help that animal, try to and inform to concerning authorities. And need to medical care, for example animal husbandry. Then create awareness about biodiversity conservation, own family to family and friends, and join organization. The students, we have lot of wildlife NGOs, for example worldwide fund for nature India. So one of the NGO try to protect this wildlife, and we can join with that in non-governmental associations, organizations, and do some for that. Then Forest Conservation Act. This act was enacted in 1980, amended in 1988. So students, this is a landmark legislation, 1992, 73rd and 74th amendment. This amendment opportunity to every locals, panchayat and local forest resources. For example, in tribal area, any forest areas are there, give opportunity to protect that people. You know, that people mainly only do harmful to that area. So teach and educate that people and give opportunity to protect that forest area and preserve the forest. When you protect the that biodiversity, we can create clean air and quality water. Then penalties. Anybody disturb or do danger to the forest having various penalties and punishment listed by this legislation. No person is allowed to make clearing or set fire to reserve forest. Not permitted to trespass into the reserve forest. Then collecting any forest product is punishable with imprisonment. So in forest, do not allow to collect the any forest product. Then what individual do? Allowed to destructive activities in your local green areas, mainly national park, wildlife sanctuaries, you know, create awareness, inform yourself with the law. Then touch with the concerning local NGOs, for example Greenpeace. Then create awareness about the existence, national parks and sanctuaries. Then pressurize the authorities to implement the forest wildlife law. You know, various law difficult to implement. So we are individual responsible to pressurize mainly this, you know, PIL, public interest litigation. We can write to file case against that type of issues. Public interest litigation means a particular issue which is affecting the society, public. So individual right to apply this file case against that. So court, Supreme Court, High Court can advise to government and concerning authority to formulate various program to solve that issues. Help to NGOs, create public pressure to change laws. Then ecologically sensitive public transport and bicycle track. So in the wildlife forest area, not try to avoid that vehicles and bio tracks, try to use. Then participate in preservation of greenery. Students, greenery everybody like, you know, not only in forest, nearby house we can make green, like for forestry. One of this theme was that urban forestry, which means urban there is no trees, so every houses can create and some type of trees in this and look like green. Next section is that issues involved in enforcement of environmental legislations. As we have discussed that many of the provisions in this act difficult to implement. The reason is that various reasons. First reason is lack of awareness. People don't know about. Well educated people as well as don't know. For example, they don't know and unawarely kill forest deer. For example, one of the this famous cine actor, you know, Salman Khan, was killed a deer and punished by the court. The person don't know about the particular act is right or not. That's why nowadays government take various these messages from the school level and college level. Everyone know about what are the dangerous species. This is education, you know, every nurse should be know about what are the dangerous species, what are the law, what are the punishment, and how to protect the environment, how to protect ourselves. Then national state level law enforcement officers must also come form concerned individuals. So which means some law, for example, in tribal area, tribal people don't know about the law, do some offense. What do? Uncognizable offense. The people don't know about it. That time, the officials need to take action, educate the people, form groups and coordinate, and try to create awareness that people how to protect their own environment as well as forest. What are the dangerous species? And must be filed a public interest litigations, as we have discussed. Then several NGOs also support to implement environmental legislations. Students, next section is that environmental impact assessment. As we had discussed earlier, every development program including government program as well as non-governmental programs, the Ministry of Environment and Forestry requires and this assessment report. The main objective of this environment impact assessment is that the various taxes imposed by the government, this tax is may be called as green tax. What do you think about green tax? A money which is used for replacing the damage. For example, started a project, the damage in water or air or soil. So this money used to reconstructing the environment. Also, this assessment is essential for feasibility study. A particular project is fit in particular area or not. For example, if a person would like to build a NGO, built a school nearby river, what happened? Maybe damage. The natural environment nearby river. Also that which is affect the old people. Then particular project may be not feasible. Reason is that that area is that flood prone. What do you think about flood prone? In the rainy season, this water may be affect that institutions. So environmental impact assessment, not only this, the public or people welfare, also a particular project welfare. And there, the development project is feasibility or not. So we are nursing professional need to concern it regarding environmental impact assessment. Mainly physical, biological, social parameters, as we have discussed. You know, Ministry of Environment and Forest concerning this, want this report from, and define that report, defining what are the impact in the water, soil, air, already we have discussed. Then citizens' actions and action groups. Land Act watchdog to protect. So every citizens are watchdog, watching the environment and protect. That's all the, these are the institutions. Water board, air board, you know, environmental board. We can advise and complaining to that authorities regarding any kinds of environmental issues. So we are every citizen and watch and protect the environment. Mainly concerning unsustainable projects. Some projects only for short term, you know, short term their benefits should be avoided. Then have to duty to perform every individual duty and right, human right. Next section, public awareness. Public awareness campaign. Electronic media, press, school, college education, green movement, advocating environmental protection. So this campaign concerning nowadays various international days are available to protect every environment and every parts of environment. We should be use environmental calendar activities. Look at this. February 2, Wetland Day, Bald Wetland Day. March 21, Forest Day. So this is a day protect the forest, forest conservation and wildlife and create awareness. Next, World Health Day, April 7. You know, these students, fact is that every any impact in this environment first directly affect the health of the people, as we know. Then April 18, Heritage Day. Heritage means traditional culture. And protect the indigenous technologies. Then Earth Day, now protect the soil, all earth, create awareness. Then June 5, Environment Day. June 11, World Population Day. August 6, Hiroshima Day. You know Hiroshima, Nagasaki? So prevent this Holocaust and nuclear accidents and pollution. Then September 16, World Ozone Day. So to prevent depletion of ozone layer. September 28, Green Consumer Day. October 1 to 7, Wildlife Week. So which is concerning the this, you know, Wildlife Protection Act. Create awareness, this the type of legislation. Then what can I do for biodiversity? So biodiversity, plant more trees, urban garden, grow a trace or balcony plants, then whatever possible, prevent trees from being cut, then keeping our hills free of settlements, then choose products in limited packing, then reduce the use of paper, then recycle paper, then reuse and gift wrapping paper, support project, what are the project, tiger project, elephant project, like this. Then do not, what you do not present flower bouquets, you know, so which is, then do not collect unnecessary leaflet. Do not use paper plates. And we can use, but reasonably should be used. Then habitat preservation. What do you do for habitat preservation? What are the habitat? Animals. Visit forest. Responsibility. Be kind to animals. Learn about birds. Students, learn about birds and see their behaviors. Protect wildlife. Have pets, feed them. Visit a zoo, learn about the animals. Then do not disturb teeth. Disturb or destroy. Use article like leather, do not use article leather from the animals, mainly wild animals. Do not catch or kill insect, mainly butterfly, Butterflies and insects are parts of biodiversity, which is support to the good environment. Do not kill small animals. Do not bring home to animals. Do not buy product like purse, wallets from the animal products. Buy products made from ivory. Ivory means, this elephant. Then do not use any wild animals. Then soil conservation. Do for soil. Every individual do. Cover the soil in your farm or garden. So protect the soil. Then a step sleep in your farm or garden prevent soil erosion. So this is one of the technique. So soil should be step by step use. So the water can be preserved and mainly soil nutrients within the soil. They do not flow away from the soil. Then prevent soil erosions. Surrounded by open space, organic matter to enrich your garden soil. So this, which means this, just avoid chemical fertilizers. Encourage to use biofertilizers. Then rotate crops to prevent the depletion of nutrition. Rotate crops means, for example, first cultivate banana, second cultivate rice, third cultivate, like this, different types of crop used to cultivate. That time different nutrient can be absorbed by that plant. So it's protect and preserve the soil. Then set up a composite pipe, which means bio products. Encourage your local zoo and farms. Then organize organically grow produce to help reduce the amount of toxic pesticides used in farms that harm soil. So try to improve these bio pesticides use. Then support environmental campaign. Do not remove grass, leaf. Do not use toxic pesticides. Then conserving water. What do for conserving water? Reduce the amount of water. Reuse the rinsing water. Water plants early in the morning to minimize evaporate. So which is, for example, our house garden. Early morning should be what put in water to avoid evaporations. Little bit of water is enough. Then soak and dishes before washing. Look for leaks in this toilet and bathrooms. Whatever plants, water only as rapidly as the soil can absorb the water. Then drip irrigation. Already we have discussed about drip irrigation. What, how much water need for a particular plant? That much water only you. Then need to drink water. Take only as much as you need to avoid wastages. Saving precious rainwater. Already we have discussed about how to rainwater harvesting. Then replace chemical like shampoo, chemical pesticides. Then do not turn your tap on full force. Do not use shower. Do not overwater garden plants. Not reasonable water only give, which is important for better growing, better yielding. Then do not pollute sources of water. Do not throw waste. This. Then conserving energy, do turn off the light, low voltage, use tube light, switch off the radio and television when not required. Use alternative source of energy. Cut down use of electrical applications. Summer, shut windows, you know, natural cooling need. Use a pressure cooker, for example, a heater, and as a to pressure the energy, protect, then turn off the stove immediately after use. Plan and keep things ready before you start cooking, which is very important. Kitchen, you know, everyone used to cook various materials. Plan to organize all the materials and then only put on the energy gases or stove to preserve, protect energy. Keep vessels closed while cooking. Switch off the gas stove. Shock cries, pulses, etc. Family to eat together. Before cooking, to reduce cooking time and save fuel. Then get your family to eat together. Select a light shade for point. Then reduce. You are reading tables near the window. Cut down on your electricity bill in natural light. Reading natural light. Then bicycle, public transport, plan your trips, walk rather than drive, vehicles serviced regularly. Then do not unnecessary light, then sunlight, you know, do not use gas here during the summer. Instead, heat water naturally with the help of sunlight. Then, do not use halogen lamp. Do not put food refrigerator when they are still hot. Then, what nuts do? So, this is a very important. For nurses, what nuts do? We have this all the knowledge. First, for biodiversity conservation, students, we are nurses, we are this end user, which means contact with families, individual in clinical settings. So this knowledge helps us to educate the client. The various diseases due to lack of biodiversity and various issues. So nurse do more than other individuals. Then habitat preservation. Mainly community health nurses in urban setting, urban health nursing, then public health concerning primary health nursing services, nurses doing wonderful role to preserve the habitat. Then soil conservation. Then educate, create awareness in the public to conserve the soil. Then conserving water. So these students, these all the every conservation health is directly affected. For example, waterborne diseases, airborne diseases, vector-borne diseases. For example, soil, various insects produced from the soil. Then habitat preservation. So we are nurses do to try to identify what are the source of disease, whether the water or soil or air, you know. So the conservation is how much important to prevent the diseases, these type of diseases. Then conserving energy. So energy use only causes the pollution. So reduce the use of reasonable energy only used to protect the environment and promote healthier well-being in our society. So nurses do more than other individuals, and we are do good for society and build healthier society to conserving the environment. Next section is that important and essentials of environmental studies in nursing. Students, these all the environmental knowledge is fundamental for nursing. First is that these all the knowledge implication apply to every nursing these services. First, nursing assessment. Nurse has been assessed the environment. For example, if a patient come into the hospital at this particular disease in the hospital, nurses assess regarding their environment, you know, where you are living. They are regarding their family. The first physical assessment and next social assessment, you know, socio-ecology, this environmental assessment. The society is, so environmental assessment is part of social assessment. If a man interact with particular environment, cause the disease. You know, for example, nearby particular any birds or any animals or nearby any industry, you know, air pollution. So which cause various kinds of respiratory issues. So nurse should be assessed the environment of the client in the clinical setting. Next, in community setting concern, which is a direct contact. It nurses directly contact with the every community environment and assess it and study about the air quality and soil, then habitat and agriculture, what are the products they have been using, for example, bio or chemical, which cause any diseases. Mainly concerning the epidemic and endemic. You know, for example, now we have been COVID-19. What is main assessment? Assess only environment. Protect the people and maintain hygiene, the environment, and save the life. So in nursing assessment, environmental study is fundamental for us. So which help us better nursing diagnosis. When we analyze environment of the client and communities, help us identify the issues. So maximum of issues derive from the environment. Okay, it's a fact. So for nursing diagnosis, this environmental assessment is very important. Then care, environmental oriented care, whether urban or rural, you know, which is a reality. particular disease due to particular environment and care for that environment and sustainable caring, which is called sustainable caring. Not blindly think about only care, okay? Which is next is that nursing intervention. So nurses can intervene various diseases in beginning stage of the diseases and promote this environment away from diseases. Then cure. Students, environment is a social medicine. If a person interact with the environment friendly, can be healthier. If a person interact with the environment harmly, affected by diseases is a fact. For example, water, air. Just think about the houses. We can use quality water in this and preserve the water. We can keep good health and contaminated water. What will happen? The waterborne diseases. So this environment is a social medicine. So we need to interact with the environment friendly. Next is that in psychology, in mental health nursing, which is a psychotherapy. Various psychotherapies based on environmental modifications, various mental illness due to environment, including first physical environment, social environment, as well as biological environment. So various psychotherapies formulated by various thinkers to treat by means of environmental modification and environmental, these factors are used to cure various mental illness as well as physical illness. Then prevention, as we know that, you know, we have been experiencing that COVID-19, prevent the disease, only environment, hygiene. Then promotion of health, holistic, physical, mental, social and sustainable health. Then nursing management. A nurse is a manager, need to concern it in hospital management, you know, biomedical waste management. Do you know that? Biomedical waste management. Then nursing education. Nurses educated need to create awareness to students regarding environment and promote and environmental oriented guidance due to the nursing students and promote healthier learning environment. Then patient health education, as we have discussed, counseling, group counseling, you know, for example, community health nurses went to the communities and organized the groups, you know, pressure groups and family counseling, individual counseling. Nursing research. Students, the nursing research, this is an important topic. So this used to the problem formulation, research design, tool formulation, data collection, data analysis, interpretation. The knowledge of environment is fundamental for nursing. Then maternal health nursing. Now, every mothers are different due to their environmental factors. This, they are living houses, nearby house, and their social cultural environment. Then child health nursing, medical surgical nursing. In medical surgical nursing, concerning the every disease, the main cause of disease, that environment. Then mental health nursing, as we had discussed, that psychotherapies. Then community health nursing, as we had discussed. So when you read the specialty books, you know, we could see that various environmental terminologies and which help us better understanding regarding each specialty in nursing, we can execution of nursing services sustainably. Then summary and conclusion. Thus, concepts such as various concepts we had been learned, environment, environmental issues, etc., etc., affect or influence health status, solve social problems, as we have discussed. For example, social problems concern mainly healthcare problems. Healthcare problems caused by the environmental issues, you know, water pollution, soil pollution, air pollution, cause the healthcare issues. We are nurses, solve it. How to solve it? Not blindly solve. First, source of the disease should be modified. Air quality, you know, we can prevent airborne diseases like this. Then social medicine, already we have discussed, environment is a medicine and environmental modification can cure the diseases, physical illness as well as mental illness, and prevent the diseases. Then essential to apply to nursing every specialties, and which is fundamental for peace and sustainable development. Then assignment on this section, assignment on environmental social issues, impact on health and diseases, role of nurse to solve it. This is excellent topic, okay, students. You can create to write the assignments and improve the cognitive skills on environmental and promote sustainable nursing practices. Thank you. List what are the waterborne, what are the airborne, so which is the cause of the pollutions in the environmental factors, okay, and vector borne diseases need to list. Okay, students, so this, thank you for everyone. Thank you all.